हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, अ वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू. डियर चिल्ड्रन, टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट द बॉन्ड पैरामीटर्स बाय विच अ कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड इज कैरेक्टराइज्ड. सो देर आर फोर बॉन्ड पैरामीटर्स अबाउट विच वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस. फर्स्ट इज बॉन्ड लेंथ, नेक्स्ट इज बॉन्ड एनर्जी, नेक्स्ट इज बॉन्ड एंगल, एंड लास्ट वन इज बॉन्ड ऑर्डर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट अवर वीडियो विद द फर्स्ट पॉइंट, दैट इज बॉन्ड लेंथ. सो फर्स्ट पैरामीटर इज bond length. So to understand bond length, assume two atoms which are far apart from each other like this. As you can see here that the distance between these two atoms is very large. So because of this large distance, there will be no interaction. No interaction means neither attraction nor repulsion. Okay. But when these two atoms come close to each other, okay, then what happens? Then initially attraction force dominant over the repulsion force. This is the reason that these two atoms will combine with each other and form molecule. Okay, like this. So here attraction force is maximum. Now what happens when these two atoms further brought close to each other? Okay. So at that condition, repulsion force start, and when repulsion force start, then these two atoms repel each other. Okay. So assume the condition at which attraction force equals to repulsion force. Okay. So the condition at which attraction force equals to repulsion force, at this condition, the distance from the center of the first nucleus to the center of the nuclei of the second atom. Okay. This distance is known as bond length. So what is bond length? Bond length is the distance from the center of the nucleus of two bonded atoms when attraction force equals to repulsion force. Okay. So this is the definition of bond length. Now I will tell you about the factors on which bond length depends. So bond length depends upon two factors. First is size of atom. So size of atom, as I told you that bond length is the sum of the, we can say, radius. Okay. This is the radius of the first atom and this is the radius of the second atom. So by this we can say that bond length equals to the R1 plus R2 if this is R1 and this is R2. So since this is the sum of the radius of the two bonded atoms, so definitely when we talk about the bigger atom, then the radius will be higher and the bond length will also be higher. So we can say with the increase in the size of atom, bond length increases. Okay. Now second point, multiplicity of bonds. So multiplicity means I am talking about double and triple bond. Okay. So when we compare double bond or triple bond with single bond, it shows the sharing of one pair of electron, it shows the sharing of two pairs of electron, and here three electron pair has to shared. Okay. So as we can say that in multiple bond, more electrons are involved in the bond formation. So definitely the atom has to come more close to each other. Okay. So in these cases, bond length will be lower. So we can say that with the multiplicity of bond, increase in the multiplicity of bond, bond length decreases. So this is about the bond length, and these are the factors. Now we'll talk about the second parameter, that is bond energy. Second point is What is bond energy? I told you that we have already discussed that why atoms combine with each other. So I told you that atoms combine with each other because they want to attain more stability, and this is why they shared or transferred their electron and form molecule. So one thing is clear from this conversation that when two atoms combine with each other to form molecule, they has to lose some amount of energy. Why? Because stability is inversely proportional to energy. So when they are gaining more stability by doing so, or by doing by making molecule, so in this condition they has to lose some amount of energy. Okay, so when two atoms come close to each other and form molecule, then in this case definitely they will lose some amount of energy. Okay, and this is the same amount of energy which is required to break the bond between these two atoms. Suppose this is hydrogen and this is hydrogen. So in order to break this bond, the amount of energy required is bond energy. Okay, so this is the definition of bond energy, or in a proper way you can say, to break one mole of bonds in a particular compound, the energy required is known as bond energy. Okay, now again we will talk about the factor of acting. So bond energy depends on size of atom, again how? So as we know that smaller the size of atom, greater will be the nuclear charge on the outermost shell. So definitely when they will form bond with the other molecule, then they interact with other atom more closely. Okay, as the nuclear charge is greater in lower size. Okay, so we can say that with the increase in the size of atom, nuclear charge on the other atom will be lower and the bond form will be weaker. So definitely the bond energy will be lower. Okay, and when the size of atom is smaller, then it will interact with the other atom more strongly, and the bond form strong bond will form, and the more amount of energy will be required to break the bond. Okay, so this is how bond energy is related with size of atom. Now again, multiplicity of bonds. So again, as we know that in double bond two pairs shared, okay, and in triple bond three pairs, and in single bond only one pair. So as more number of electron will involved in the bond formation, a stronger bond will be formed and definitely more energy will be required. So we can say with the multiplicity of bond, with the increase in multiplicity of bond, bond energy will be increased. Okay, so this is how bond energy depends on these two factors. Okay, now we will talk about the next parameter, that is bond angle. Third one is bond angle. So we have already discussed about the covalent bond, that in covalent compounds the bond formed, means covalent bond, are directional in nature. Okay, so what is mean by directional? Directional means the bond will form in a particular direction. Okay, as in H2O, the bond will form in a particular direction like this. Okay, in methane, the bond will form in a particular direction, in a particular direction like this. Okay, so as the covalent bond are directional in nature, so definitely the bond will form in a particular direction in space, and definitely there will be a particular angle between two bonds in each and every molecule. Okay, like this, and in ammonia also, and you can take many more examples here. Okay, so in this way the angle formed between two bonds in a covalent compound is known as bond angle, and this is formed because of the directional nature of covalent bond. Okay, so this is about the bond angle. Now we will discuss the last parameter, that is bond order. Bond order is an important topic. Bond order. So what is bond order? Bond order are the number of bonds present between the two atoms. For example, in H2, as we know that only one bond is present. So bond order for H2 molecule is 1. For O2, double bond is present. So bond order for oxygen molecule is 2. And for nitrogen, as we know, triple bond is formed, means bond order for nitrogen is 3. So bond order is the number of bonds present between the two atoms. So these are the four parameters by which a covalent bond is characterized. Okay, thank you.